technology is really easy to use. Like, it's just like one swipe on my phone and I can see the past like 24 hours of my levels.
Going really good, Drina.
Technology has made it a lot easier for me compared to my dad and my granddad. Like, my dad had to constantly have injections and could only like test every 3 days, and I can see it like in 2 seconds. I was diagnosed at 2 years old, and yeah, I've always been sailing, like basically since I was born. So the Dexcom, it's like really helping because I take my phone on the boat, so then my coaches and parents can constantly read my levels and make sure I'm all okay, and if I'm just a bit tired or if I'm actually having a hypo. So everyone can like stop stressing a lot more, and I can stop stressing, and so I can hear the alarms if I'm low or high.
It is a huge relief to know that she's got that safety on the water without us always having to be there.
This is definitely a very big step, and I would describe this as a revolutionary step because this is the first baby step towards a complete artificial pancreas system.
7.3, all good.
This is the first one which actually controls the insulin delivery.
Hey Connor, so how's your week been?
My week's been pretty good, yeah.
Good. And you've been in auto mode?
Yeah.
85% of time, that's great.
Yeah.
This system essentially is a semi-automated system because the background basal insulin is completely controlled by the sensor glucose levels. It is almost like being in a car which is on cruise control. So the basal insulin is completely delivered based on the sensor glucose level. While it is still manual entry of carbohydrates, that's whatever the child decides to eat, has to be still entered into the pump, and that's the manual component, and hence this is a semi-automated system, and that's what the current closed-loop system is all about.
I spent about 6 months on the system already, and I've loved it so much, and I don't think I can move back to the older technology.
And let's pop it in. Yep, straight out, and hold it, pull it out, beautiful. And just connect the transmitter and wait for the flashing light.
I wear a continuous glucose monitor, a CGM, which talks to the pump and gives my blood glucose reading. And my pump can take that information and react to it. So if my blood levels are higher, it'll give me a higher amount of insulin. If my blood glucose is lower, it'll give me a lower amount of insulin.
So technology has its challenges, and some of them being just being a continuous attachment to the body, the accuracy of the sensors, which definitely is improving, the skin reactions, especially seen with continuous glucose monitors, then the pumps, and the alerts with the continuous glucose monitors, which need to be individualized.
Technology and young people, yeah, they kind of go hand in hand. So like, yeah, my generation really grown up with technology and are really familiar with it, and for younger families looking to embrace that sort of thing, it's the future of diabetes, really.
I've been able to return to work, which has, you know, contributed to the family income. I'm able to drop her off here and not have to panic all the time. Sleep through the night, independence, we can share her sugar levels with other people, so the school nurse has it, her teachers, her coach.
Good. All right, we'll just double check where you're at. Oh, 6.2.
Perfect. For other young people, it definitely makes a massive change on my life. It's almost like you don't have diabetes, you only just need to like check it a couple of times.
And eventually, the whole dream is to have a fully automated closed-loop system where there is minimal intervention by the user, and it's a system doing all the management. Freedom from finger pricks, a good night's sleep, freedom from injections, and essentially freedom from diabetes is what technology is trying to pursue in the long run.